And suddenly it's winter, guys. 15 degrees outside. It's freezing cold. It is freezing cold. Welcome back to another episode, Unplugged TV, freezing cold Australia. I know we had a loss of capacity yesterday after washing the car. So yeah, another 0.1 ampere hour down for no particular reason. So don't wash your car ever. And tonight they turned off the power. The car was charging for only probably an hour, maybe 1.5, 1.6 amp. And this morning I looked on my Sonoff app and there was nothing. I said, oh, that's not good, there's no power. So, emergency charging situation again. 10 amp and we've got 21 kilometers now. That's definitely not enough to get me to work and back. And I don't think the club is open today. So we are down to 39.5 ampere hours now after another 175 kilometers traveled and 8 days. I'll show you here how it looks like. And as you can see from the graphs, it seems like it's almost the same degradation I had before with the old battery reset and the new battery reset and the new battery and the procedures carried out. It's the same degradation showing at any point of time. So something is definitely not right. It is either, I don't know what it is. I don't know. Speculations. I think I've tried everything. I tried. I did not fully charge the car for 2 weeks in a row. I did not fully discharge the car for 2 weeks in a row and still experienced loss in capacity. The state of health is going down whatever I do. And of course I've sent another email to Mitsubishi this morning giving them the latest data about the car, showed them the graph and also the table with all my findings and records of state of... Ooh, a bit fast. So I'm of course very keen to hear what the manufacturer of this great product wants to tell me and how we go from here. Yeah, I don't know. This degradation loss yesterday, this drop yesterday, 0.1 ampere hour, just while washing the car, this doesn't make sense. You know, I measured the battery before I washed the car and then afterwards and it dropped 0.1 ampere hour. So what is the trigger to make the BMU recalculate the state of health? It cannot be kilometers because I drove literally 5 meters only back and forward. And it couldn't be time because it took me only 1 hour to wash the car in the afternoon. So what has triggered the BMU to say this battery is not as good anymore, I need to rate it down? This is total bullshit. And guys, biggest news, we are now on change.org. Yes, my good old friend Jacob from Switzerland has started a petition over there, which you can sign. He explained very well what is going on with the Outlander PHEV and is trying to urge Mitsubishi to do something about this software nightmare. And if you want to sign, I link his petition down in the description. I have signed this morning and he has already over 200 signatures out of the goal of 500. So good on you, Jacob. Thanks for starting this petition. So guys, we have arrived with a 39%, 15 ampere hours and only 6 kilometers left. So only hope is if the club is open, I can recharge a little bit here. I haven't used fuel for a while actually. What a shame. No power, no charge. Wrong side. Lunch break. I've just seen the club is not open, so I cannot recharge. I will use a little tiny bit of fuel today. Also, I have just read the petition from Jacob on change.org. So this is exactly what we need. We need more pressure, we need more initiatives, we need more information, getting people together and get things done. I am a member of the Norwegian BMU, BMS battery issue group as well. Give these guys a little bit of a heads up in there, some advice, some help. And I have just seen it popped up on my news feed on the right hand side in Facebook that there is a BMU, BMS group in Canada as well. There are only 27 people in there at the moment, but that's how you start. You start with one person and then and more people join these groups and you get together. That's how we started here in Australia, one person. So it's great to see all these groups popping up everywhere now in all these countries. Get organized, get together, share information, share data, share your communication with Mitsubishi and develop strategies. Eventually we will get there. I hope we will get there, really, yeah. I've sent another email to Mitsubishi just now asking them for directions now because the deadline was last Wednesday. Then there was Easter breaks and the holiday here, so everyone is back today. Of course, haven't heard back because this is low priority here. So send them a reminder email. I would like to have a direction today or tomorrow. So guys, and if it wouldn't be enough, some people still trolling the forums and saying there's nothing wrong with the PHEV. This is only affecting a very limited, only a few cars out in this world. And if there would be more, there would be large lines and long lines in the dealerships and everyone would complain. People do complain. They do complain. Yes, yes, there would be long lines and there are long lines, but nobody makes this public. That is the point. And it's not only a few cars. It is a very, very few cars which don't have problems. And if you are in the market of buying an Outlander PHEV, I'm not telling you not to buy one. I'm telling you, if you are happy with the warranty provided for your car in your country, and you know there is a problem with the battery, with the software, with the four-wheel drive, and you're still going ahead buying this car, spend your $50,000 Australian dollars, $55,000 Australian dollars, or €35,000 or wherever you are. Spend this money on this car and don't ever look at any figures at all. And really, some people saying, look, drive this car, have fun, don't worry. If you know there is something wrong and you can overlook this, just do it if you are into this. I personally cannot do that. If I know there is something wrong, I need to find out why. I need to fix it. This is not how I function, but if you are happy with the car as it is, it's your best car ever. But don't hang around in these forums and troll people. Really, it is not limited to only a few cars which have these problems. It is 99.99% of all the cars having these problems. Just go to the phevwatchdog.net website and you can log in as a guest. You don't need to have the Watchdog app, you don't need an Android phone. Just go to the website, log in as a guest and have a look at the insane degradation of the darker green dots on the left-hand side of the first graph you find in there. This is how deep the degradation goes down in brand new 2019 models. And then make a decision if you want to go ahead and buy this car. And there's no fix for these cars. There's no recall, nothing. People complaining and Mitsubishi tells them, go away. Everything is within specifications. And before you buy this Outlander PHEV, used or new, do your research. Get something in written from the dealer. What kind of battery warranty you will have on this car in terms of kilometers, time and degradation. If you are happy with this warranty statements from your dealer and you don't mind losing capacity all the time and eventually your mind, go ahead and buy it. It's a great car. I say this all the time. It's a fantastic car. It is great, but it has a huge, huge, huge problem. Or maybe two problems if you count in the four-wheel drive issue as well. And both of these issues can potentially be fixed by a software upgrade. But just don't post comments on forums like saying there's nothing wrong with the car, don't believe these other ones, these few other ones which had problems with their battery, these are single cases, this is not the majority. Total, absolute, 100%. Ah, finally made it through the day. Let's see, maybe I have gained about 5 ampere hours while parking, so I can make it home. Plus 0.3 ampere hours, it gives me 7 kilometers! 7 kilometers for a 15 kilometer trip! Damn car! Car is not working as designed. Yeah, I don't know what that is with this power. They turn off the power in the night. The car charged only for a few, you know, it charged only for maybe an hour or so. And then they, what? Wasn't me. So they usually turn off the power at about 5 o'clock when peak time starts. Then it turns back on at about 9:30 or so. And I schedule my timer to midnight or 1 a.m. to charge the car. But for the last couple of days, it turned the power off at about midnight, and it didn't come on until 7 or 8 o'clock in the morning. So something is going on. They may be doing some upgrades somewhere on the electrical grid, or maybe they are doing some tests because they want to get rid of this tariff, because I get my power cheaper on this tariff and they don't want that. I guess we are ending up with this time, with this time-based tariff where you have a normal tariff during the day and then you've got a high peak tariff between peak times. Maybe they are testing something. And why is he not driving there? Jeez, come on. I've got only 6 kilometers to go here. Well, I guess I'll find out tonight. So I'm not sure what is going on there, why they are doing this, but it is annoying when you wake up and you check your app, you check your Instagram, and the car is not charged. And then you need to get out early in the morning before anything else and enroll the extension cable and charge from a normal power point just to get to work. Damn it, the engine started. Still 2 kilometers left. So guys, back home, made it. Used half a liter of fuel or something, I don't know. So biggest announcement of today is obviously the change.org petition from Jacob. And if you haven't already, please go on this website, link is down below, and sign the petition. Make Japan, Mitsubishi Japan, aware of what is going on, that there is an actual issue with the car, with the software, with the BMU, and make them to provide a fix. As always, thanks for watching, thanks for your support. This is Andy with an empty battery signing off. You stay charged and we will see us soon. Ah, I've got an email from Mitsubishi back that they have a meeting this afternoon and will get back to me shortly. Okay guys, see you in the next video. Bye bye.